So you want to do some animation with your environment still visible. How do you do that?
So here I have my shot open. Your shot will look different, of course. I want to show you a couple of tips. And I want to do this video because during the streams while creating this shot, two people asked me about how I manage the visibility of the environment. First off, you have the display layers, where here you can toggle the visibility of objects. You can add things from your scene on these layers and change whether they're visible or not, whether you can see them during the play blast, or if they're simply there as a reference, which is the R. But this still might not solve your problem if you want to have the geometry there and be able to view it or not from a specific angle. So for example, I want to be able to see him walking while the camera is outside the room. I want to be able to animate efficiently. So I want to have the environment be not selectable, but then only visible through a specific perspective. I will select the wall, put it on a layer. Another quick thing I could do is disable geometry selection from up here, so you can focus on animating the rig. One thing I've seen people do, and sometimes I still do it because it's quite fast, is to set the geometry from the display layer as a template, which means you can only see the wireframe and you can still animate while kind of knowing the boundaries of your environment. But that's when I got the questions while streaming, because that's not what I did. I had the walls visible while at the same time animating, and how I did that is the subject of this video. So first you enable selection to your geometry. In my case, let's say this back wall. And if we check at the moment, the back side of the wall is black. So when the camera is out of the room, we can see our animation. We can't see our beautiful character walking here. But drum roll, because this is the tip. If we go to the attribute editor while having our geometry selected, head over to the shape node and render stats. And here we can set our geometry to be or not be double-sided, which in turn makes one side of the geometry transparent. So then I can do the same for the rest of the walls in my room, in my scene here. Because here I will find the opportunity to show you. Sometimes when you try to do this, the wrong side will be transparent, not the one you want. And all you have to do is click opposite, because you want the opposite side to be transparent. So now if I go all around my room, if I pivot around, you see that the walls disappear according to my perspective. Well, the perspective of the camera. And now I can finally set my environment geometry as a reference and make it basically unselectable. And I can focus on animating without having to toggle display layers on and off all the time. And that's it, my quick little neat trick in Maya. Now go do some cool animation and see if it applies in your scene.
I hope you found that tip helpful. Whether you already knew it or not, make sure to hit the like button or smash it if you want. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay creative. Bye.